Thank you for coming. What's more thrilling is to see so many young faces, so many new faces. And speaking of young faces, when I was in the US doing my PhD, that was many moons ago, I was assigned to teach psychology 101. On the first day, when I walked into the lecture hall, it was full of students, American students. There must have been a couple hundred of them. When I walked in, a hush fell upon the room. And everybody just turned to look at me, probably wondering, what's this Chinese dude doing here? You gotta remember, this is days before Mulan and Crazy Rich Asians, right? So I walked in, got to my little front, set my things down, I picked up the marker, and I started writing my name in Chinese. I turned to them, and I said, welcome to Chinese 101. If you're in the wrong class, please leave. And there was this confused murmur, and all the students started opening up their backpacks, checking their schedules, and some of them got up to leave. I told them, I'm only kidding, just sit down. You're in the right place. And I relieved laughter that broke out. From then on, I had their undivided attention. Now, I was thinking of doing the same, playing the same trick here. I walk up in white shirt, white pants. But I thought with this crowd that would have been too dangerous. Don't worry. You're in the right place. But I want to ask you this serious question. I want to ask you, why are you here? I don't mean to be good. Why are you really here? Why do you take trouble on a Saturday afternoon when you could be doing 100 other things to be here with us? I want you to think about it. And if you haven't figured out yet, you will by the end of this presentation. Now let me give you a hint. It has to do with this word. It's a simple word, a short word, it's five letters. And yet it's one of those funny words. Not funny in the ha-ha sense, but funny in the sense that it's hard to describe. It's hard to define, isn't it? If I were to ask you right now, right, you give me a definition of trust. What is trust? You'll be struggling. And yet, it's a word that we instinctively recognize when we see it, when we feel it. Why? Why? Because trust takes more than mere words to establish. It takes deep. In other words, trust comes from not what you say, but what you do. Think about it. Have you met someone whom you just met who's out to convince you of something, and he just prattles on and on, and at the end of it he says, trust me. I don't know about you, but when I hear something like that, I react in the opposite manner. I instinctively recoil. He hasn't done anything to demonstrate why I should trust him. He's just telling me to do it. As I said, trust is not for our sake. It's what we do. So, when he says this...
That's why we solve problems. Like cost of living. How can we make life better? Not quite burdened, lighter.
But he does this. When he says this,
let us be prepared to buckle down, work, even sacrifice.
But collect this. When he says this,
we've worked hard for the seniors. The seniors who deserve peace of mind in their golden years, who deserve to live out their years with dignity.
But we see this. When you say one thing and you do the diametric opposite, that's when you lose the people's trust. Because trust doesn't come from what you say, it comes from what you do. But the fact that the present PAP cannot be trusted still doesn't answer the question of why you're here. Just because you don't trust the PAP doesn't mean that you automatically end up supporting the SNG. I'm going to suggest to you that your being here today has to do with who you are. I think I know you well enough. You're the sort of person who cannot bear to see politicians who seek self-glorification, who place themselves above the people they claim to serve, and politicians who seek self-enrichment. Am I right?
Yes.
You cannot look the other way when you see our elderly poor have to clean tables and collect cardboard and commit suicide because the state refuses to help. You cannot numb yourself to the injustice that you see around you or ignore the fact that our country desperately needs change. Well, guess what? These are the exact same values that the SDP holds dear. We believe that politicians should serve the nation with humility and with a spirit of self-sacrifice, not serve for the sake of money. We believe in giving the voiceless a voice and empowering the powerless. We believe in justice, not just in the legal sense, but in all its forms, political, social, economic. We believe in a system where people come before profit, rights before riches, wisdom before wealth. These are the values that we pledge our service and loyalty. These are the values that we spend our lives fighting for. Take someone like Paul Tambayo. With his leadership skills, his standing in society, his qualifications, the PAP would have loved to have him join them. If he had signed on the dotted line, he would walk right into cabinet today and become minister. But that's not the case. The PAP's values are not his values. Instead, he believes in the SDP's values, in fighting for that little guy, the guy who despairs when he looks at the hospital bill because his wife needs treatment for cancer, for the retiree whose desperation grows when he realizes that he cannot withdraw his CPF savings, for the housewife whose burden multiplies with every increase in price and fees, for the young mother who gets evicted from her HDB flat because she cannot afford the rent, and for the elderly abe whose desperate loneliness and poverty tries to climb over the parapet and with one step end it all. All this amidst a government whose young junior ministers feel so entitled that they say they cannot live on a salary of $50,000 a month. Fighting for justice. Justice in its most profound sense. Fighting for the defenseless. These are the values that have brought thinking Singaporeans to the SDP. Values that have kept us together. All these years, come hell or high water, through the most trying times and the darkest moments. They are the same values that you, all of you, believe in. And that, my friends, is why you are here. Someone once remarked to me that the SDP does not have support. It has beliefs. They have to leave us because we stayed true to our values all these decades, taking all the richness that the PAP has thrown at us, but never flinching, never wavering in our commitment to our country, to our fellow citizens. You've come to know that we'll always be here. Which brings me to the other reason why we're here. You know that we're here for the long haul. Why is it important? Think about the people whom you trust. Maybe it's your mother, your dad, your spouse, or even your best friend. Now ask yourself, why do you trust them? Because they give you lots of money? Because they always tell you things that are sugar and spice and all things nice? I don't think so. The reason you trust them is that they are always there. They always have your back. You know you can depend on them. That's why you trust them. We've been around for more than a quarter of a century, actually. 35 years, more than 35 years. Let me tell you this. Nobody is getting rid of us anytime soon. Many of you have come up to me over the years, most recently when I was selling my books, and asked me not to give up. And whenever I hear this, I always think of the late Lim Chiu Siong. I was born when he was in his prime, fighting for Singapore and struggling mightily against the colonialism for a democratic and independent Singapore. I've heard stories. He was a charismatic leader, giant of a man, who genuinely cared for his fellow men and women. Utterly selfless was how author T.J.S. George put it. He fought fearlessly against the British and was beloved by Singaporeans. He once told a packed rally, "The British say you cannot stand on your own feet. Stand up!" To a person, the crowd roared and they roared back. I met Chiu Siong in 1995 at a friend's house one evening. And throughout dinner, he didn't utter a single word. Even when the conversation became animated and vivacious, when the subject of politics came around, you remained stoic and silent. I couldn't reconcile in my mind that this was the same man who had captivated and energized an entire nation. A dinner guest that pulled me aside and told me that Chiu Siong is not like what he was in the 1950s. Perhaps the years under detention without trial had taken a toll on him. He seemed a shell of the man he was. Then at the end of the evening, just as we were about to take our leave, he suddenly turned to me, he held my forearm, and he softly said three words, "Don't give up." A year later, Lim Chiu Siong passed away. It's been 20 years since he said those three words to me. I took them to heart. And like I promised many of you, I will not give up. Not when we've got so much to do. I've had the honor of fighting with the bravest, most patriotic Singaporeans. Singaporeans like J.B. Jeyaretnam, Francis Seow, Tan Liang Hong. And I've had the privilege of learning from political luminaries like Chia Tai Po, Sai Zahari, Lim Hock Siew, Ho Sui Kai. We stand on their shoulders as we climb ever higher towards a free and just and democratic Singapore. Through all the laughter and the tears, through the highs and lows, we're still here. Trust, as I said, comes from knowing that someone whom we say we trust, being there all the time, rock solid, no matter what. We were here yesterday, we are here today, and we will be here tomorrow. That knowing that we'll always be here is why you are here today. For me, trust is something that you build up, however long it takes, however many lives your opponent gives, however much you have to sacrifice. For me, trust is not a campaign punchline. It is my word. And my word is my honor. Without trust, I am nothing. My honor cannot be bought. It cannot be sold to the highest seller. I make you this promise. That as long as this old heart continues to beat, as long as these lungs continue to breathe, I'll be here. But I want you to make this mean this promise to you. That you'll be here to fight alongside us. We need you. Not behind us, not in front of us, but beside us, arm in arm, shoulder to shoulder, fighting the good fight. Only then can we bring out the best in our fellow men and women in this country. Only then can we build a better tomorrow for ourselves and for our children. So are you with me, my friend? Yes. Are you ready for change? Yes. The change is in the air. But it will remain in the air if you don't get involved. Are you ready for change?
Yes.
You must be the change that you want to see.
Yes.
Are you really ready for change?
Yes.
Then let's pick up the fight and let's make change happen. Let's press on and fight. Really fight for what we believe in. Let's get active. Let's press on. Let's get it on. Thank you.